So the affirmative has said that building this wall would benefit the country both economically and by reducing the harm of dangerous people who are flooding in by bringing in drugs. Actually, she said that the current border is failing, which is actually false. Ever since the Clinton era for the Operation Gateway, and then later on Bush's Fence Act in 2006, the amount of people that have been crossing the border has reduced to 1/10 what it was over the course of 10 years, meaning that immigrants coming in from Mexico is actually reducing without the need of a huge wall. So that defeats also her claim that the borders are too lenient on their policies. Also for drugs being smuggled, I do have a comment here from Politico that the wall will not stop drug cartels or the flow of weapons, because cartels already use the checkpoints that anyone can enter or exit the country in to transport illegal products into the country. So they're not crossing the dangerous natural borders to get into this country, and they're not crossing fences or walls that are heavily patrolled. They're crossing the checkpoints and smuggling parts at a time for weapons or small doses of drugs in through those checkpoints and using places that will always have to be open. And if her argument were to be that we have no checkpoints and it's just a solid wall and no one can come in or out of the country, then that seems really illogical to just seal off an entire country and anyone else who comes in from South America. That would hurt the economy because of tourism for anyone that comes in from the south, from Mexico and Southern America, as well as anyone that comes in to visit family. So because of this, this will not expand the economy. It will actually hurt it economically from tourism and just anyone that travels back and forth between the country.